Hello, DivX Maximus. I'm here to show my friend how to use the DivX Converter Plus 10.1. They won't show the 10.1, but I know that that is the latest release, which just came out a few weeks ago. It is the only one that supports the HEVC 4K. I highly recommend this. It will completely squash your videos down to sizes that are unbelievable and still leaving them lossless. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go to this website. You'll see the link is right here. After you're done that, go to download now. After you're done download, of course, I'm not going to install the file because I've already installed it. But while you're installing it, the thing that you want to watch out for is you'll have some options. And one of the options will be a blanked out box that needs to be checked. And it is, and it, what you want to do is you want to click on it and it says install HEVC plugin. That is very important because without that, you can't use it. You might as well just also install the rest of the stuff except for the web player. The movie player is definitely good because it works with the movies themselves, so it's good for testing, so keep that too. After you're done with that, let's look at the software that can be used with this and all that. First you want to do is you want to go to the executable, or it might be a shortcut on your desktop. It says DivX Converter. I already have it opened up, so here we go. Let me close it again so I can just show you everything how it's supposed to work. So let's open this back up. Maybe it wasn't ready yet. Okay, here we go. It's opened up. What we want to do is we want to add a file. Of course, I don't have the TMNT2 anymore because I already have HVAC. This one I need to redo in HVAC. You can see that the thing is 15.5 gigabytes. The size of this is half the size of the Turtles in Time video. And the Turtles in Time video was huge. That was 35 gigabytes. Like, that's pretty massive. And what I did was I took that, and I think it's in my videos folder. The DivX movies. Oh, here it is. TMNT2 videos. I turned a 35 gigabyte file into 1.36. It's really good quality. It's completely lossless. I highly recommend people to use HVAC for now, for at least storing their files until YouTube comes to their senses and let us upload these files onto YouTube. So what you want to do is to actually start the process of converting them to HVAC. You want to grab a TMNT2 or whatever the hell it is that you're going to be recompressing. let's see. So we got this thing loaded. As you see, they got two bars. This is for video. The audio tracks is for audio, of course. Let's click on this, actually. This is really important for you to do. Right here, we'll give you your options of which encoders that you want to do. This probably wouldn't happen if you're on a 1080p screen, but for right now, I'm doing something else. Okay, so you've got these options. As you see, this one, this is what I use to upload to YouTube. So that 1.35 gigabyte TMNT video is going to actually end up being like 8 gigabytes or something with this. But I usually convert with the HVAC, and then I put it, use this just in case something happens. But what you want to do for the compression, though, is you see how all these says HEVC? Yeah. Those are the ones you want. So pick HEVC UHD 4K. This will put you in the future. That's the one you want. So pick that. Okay, so now that that's done, we can go to output and see your options here. You can see you have a custom resolution. This is what I use to put my stuff at high quality. You know, of course, I had to do some math before I do it, but I can do pretty much any size, resize it to anything. The best thing is to use integers, and if you're using interlaced videos, try to do another method. For instance, TMNT had an output of 320 by 224, but the picture size was 344 by 240. Usually the best thing to do with this, in a simple way of doing it without the reconstructive surgery that I do, is usually leave this horizontal the same and put this back down at 224, and that will make sure you won't have that fuzzy interlaced problems if you're using interlaced video. Another really important thing to do is right here where it says encoding mode, you want to always have it at best quality. So there you go. I think that's right. So we're not doing a 4K video. The 4K video would have been like something gigabytes. But you see, as I took a 1.5 gigabyte file or 1.3 gigabyte file and I turned it into 76.27 megabytes, and it's lossless. It's beautiful. It's an absolute wonder that this thing is around. I just found out about it. They just released it. It's incredible. I'm so glad that it's around. The only problem that I can usually find with these things is that sometimes, like, if you have a big video, this has happened to me once. It might just be in TMNT, but I've been kind of weird about that lately. And usually these lossless AVs that I use usually do MP3s. But what you can do is you can use VLC. I had to go back to the snap folder where my movies are recorded. Main plus. Open this up. Snap. TMNT. Open with VLC. And when you're in VLC, go to media. Convert and save. When you're in convert and save, go in TMNT, pick that. Don't worry about the rest of it. Hit convert and save. It will give you an option of where you want to put the thing in. And hold up. I had to stop the sound. This is kind of annoying. Once you've done that, you have to hit convert and save. Go into this folder right here. I usually just do MP3 since it's MP3 anyway. See the audios, you got all these things convert. And then you put the destination and you hit start. And usually my stuff ends up in music right here. Well, TMNTA, you get it. So what you can do to fix the problem is here, the plus sign right here. Click on that and choose something. I think it's in my music folder, TMNT. Okay, go into that. After you're done with that, you don't want the original track on. So what you want to do is pick this, and then you don't want ACC since it's MP3 anyway. Put it in MP3 and hit OK. What happens here is if you click the box, it will make sure that that sound runs. So you don't want the original one, but the second one that you left, you have to have that box clicked. So that way it will save. And then just start, and it will convert. And you'll have a really small, wonderful file that you can convert to any format, and it's very useful. I hope this video is helpful. Take care.